Do you remember Speed Punks? How about Speed Freaks? If you remember one of those games, you're in luck because they're the same game! Let's talk about it. What's up guys, Jeremy Bandicoot here, back with another video, and today is the start of my brand new series called Do You Remember, where I review a TV show, movie, video game, whatever, has been lost to the annals of time, but were really, really good, but nobody seems to remember them. Today, I'm talking about the PlayStation 1 title, Speed Punks, or as it was known everywhere else but America, Speed Freaks. This was a game made by Funcom, who I swear to God, had the best intro to a game in the history of video gaming. I just love it. I mean, seriously, just watch the intro to this game in its entirety. I absolutely adore it. It's a great time, don't worry. Now, wasn't that just a treat? So as the name implies, this is a racing game, but the racers are literally children. Like, imagine Crash Team Racing had sex with the Rugrats, and you have this amazing spawn of a game. Literally though, this game was amazing, and I have no idea why it isn't remembered or featured more. It literally has everything you could ever want in a kart racer, from memorable and fun characters, to exciting gameplay, to awesome looking tracks and environments, and even really creative shortcuts to make the track even more immersive. In this game, you have a choice of 9 playable characters, and while that might not seem like a lot, the original CTR featured 15 playable characters, you have to remember that this was a game of its time, and you should also remember that Mario Kart 64 only had 8 playable characters, so the roster doesn't matter too much, does it, Nintendo? Mario Kart 64 can suck my- regardless of the amount of characters this game has or lacks, they do more than make up for in the quality of each character. You have Tempest, an angry evil child that I swear to God, if he was my spawn, I'd drown him in his alpha bits. You have Monte Carlo, on the nose there, isn't it? The coolest kid you'll ever meet because he never shows any fear, loves ripping off Speed Racer, and his name is literally Monte Carlo. You have Monica, the spoiled elementary school sorority bitch who doesn't want to break her nails. You've got Tabitha, who's literally Angelica from the Rugrats. You've got Tetsuo, a weird Naruto engine junkie hybrid who reminds me of what happens when the state of Alabama really gets out of control with their breeding. You have Brains, the literal Stewie Griffin, Dexter from Dexter's Lab, Professor X hybrid, who literally embodies the benefits of a cesarean section. You have Cosworth, Monty's sentient dog, who literally has the anatomy of Rayman. And finally, you have Beamer, Brain's robot that is the superior driving robot and will soon take over our planet and enslave us all. And last but not least, we have my absolute favorites. They're known as Buster and Wedgie, who were just utter bliss. I swear to God, every time I see these two on a monitor, I just cry with happiness because something about them just makes me so happy. I mean, look at these dudes. How can you not love them? All of these characters have so much charm to them, and it makes for extremely fun racing and gameplay when you're racing as or against them. The characters, coupled with the art style of the game, all combine to make it an experience to remember, and I have no idea how this game got lost to time and is not remembered nearly as much as it should be. The gameplay is simplistic enough, it's very reminiscent of Mario Kart, in that you really don't have to do much other than boost and use your weapons to win a race. But make no mistake that this game can be extremely difficult. A big difference between this game and Mario Kart is that it follows an arcade-style racer, wherein you have to collect certain electric tokens littered throughout the track to fill your boost meter. Once you begin to fill your boost meter up, you can use it for a boost, but if you fill it up all the way, you get a super flashy mega boost, which is just awesome to use. As a kid, I struggled with a lot of the boss races, and even going back and playing it as an adult makes me rage every time and again, just because it does take a considerable amount of knowledge of both the controls as well as the track layout itself to win a race, especially the boss races. Looking at you, Beamer. Seriously though, the Beamer boss race is notorious for being one of the most challenging bosses in all of video gaming, not just a kart racing title. This boss is insane, and I'm ashamed to say that to this day, I still haven't beaten him. Even outside the boss races, sometimes you have to make sure that you hit every shortcut on the track to even have a chance at winning, and at that point, you have to pray to God that you get the right power-ups so you can shove the suppository at the dog's ass and overtake him to win the race. Oftentimes, though, I don't even care if I'm winning or losing. This is the type of game that you just enjoy playing. I can't tell you how many times I played this game with my dad when I was a child, just because this is one of the few games that he could actually play and have a good time playing. Maybe it's the insane difficulty of this game that makes it less memorable than a lot of racing titles, but I feel that there could be a truly competitive scene built around this game if enough people fall in love with it the way I did. It's just the natural charm of the game, and that makes it more memorable and fun. And there's no doubt in my mind that it needs to be remembered as the lost gem of time that it truly is. Like any other game though, this isn't one without its flaws, namely the sound design. As an adult gamer used to silky smooth audio in my games, I've been absolutely spoiled rotten and completely forgot the kind of dribble I used to listen to in my games. Just take a listen to the engine sounds and power-up sounds in this game. It is literally like an attack on the senses, but after a few races, you tend to get used to it. The graphics also look a bit dated, but the comprehensive and cohesive art style make up for it to an extent. These are really the only gripes I have with the game, as otherwise it's a truly fun experience to just pick up and play and have a good time with. So if you can find a physical copy, or even an emulated copy, disclaimer, I do not endorse the use of illegal emulation, I strongly suggest you give this game a play if you haven't already. If you do remember playing this as a kid, get your asses back on the track and race your heart out. I guarantee it will be a shot of nostalgia for you, and you'll have fun all over again, just like when you were a kid. When you had no responsibilities, no bills, no tie-downs, no worries. Man, that sounds like a paradise. If you'll excuse me, I'm gonna go play this game some more so I can remember what it feels like to be a kid again, and not have to pay my rent. Yeah, that was a good time. But that's just my thoughts on Speed Freaks, punks. Let me know what your thoughts in the comments are below. And if you haven't already, be sure to smash that like button and the notification bell and all that promotional stuff. Subscribe, consider subscribing, that'd be great. It really helps me out and I really appreciate it. So on that note, thank you guys again for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Get on with the racing with the little boy and the dog. Oh my god.